after 185 episodes, they have an idea of what our strengths are.
Yeah.
And so I think you've seen the evolution of the banter between, you know, Kenzie and Deeks. They definitely write to the comedic elements that, that we bring to the show. And they're also very open about finding things in the moment, which is that you do one prescripted as dialogue written, and then you can try stuff. And some of my favorite kind of reactions and moments in the show are moments in which they weren't really... moments in which they weren't... it wasn't on the page. One of my favorite scenes still, forever, is after Deeks is tortured and he's going through a period where he's not able to sleep for weeks, and she comes over with Chinese food, and it's this great scene that they played in a two-shot where there's a bunch of, like, really honest, natural improvisation. And ended up being one of my favorite scenes. You find moments that aren't prepared for, and her reactions, she's so good at reacting to those moments. That
especially when he's off camera and says things that he knows will get a reaction off of me, which are unsayable at this time.
Yeah.
But here's the cool thing, too, is because I think that Eric and I have created a certain dynamic over the last 7 years, sometimes they'll leave, because what it is, for those who don't know, it's, you know, a camera on him, a camera on me, and it's behind us and everything. But when you have certain moments like this one that he's talking about, or during the proposal when Kenzie's in the wheelchair, sometimes you kind of have to have a camera on both of us simultaneously, because the things that you get in the moment are going to be different every single take. One might take you to a more emotional place, a quieter place, whatever it is. And so to get the matching reaction from the other person, you have to ensure that there's a camera on both of you. Otherwise, you have sort of mismatched takes between us. And so, you know, we always know when there's a camera either on both of us or at the same time on each one of us. We always know that that's a moment that him and I get to play more around with, because it's going to cut nicely in editing whenever they do that. So, and about the input, too, there was, that time where Kenzie's in recovery in season 8. Mm. And, you know, she can't walk, and she's going through times where she's depressed, sad, angry, but it's all very negative feelings. And so between us and the director, we kind of felt like we needed a relief from that, something a little bit sweeter between them to show the sort of roller coaster that it is to recover from something like what she was going through. And so we asked our Scott Gemmel, who's our showrunner and one of our writers, and he wrote my whole arc throughout the recovery. And we said, hey, do you think we can get something a little sweet? And so literally over lunchtime, he wrote a scene and we shot it that day. Mm-hmm. And it just fits so beautifully. And if for those who've watched it, it's the scene where they wake up in the hospital and she's like, I don't want to be here anymore. And he's like, I know, but you have to. And it's just a sweet moment before everything crashes again. And that was written on the day and shot literally a few hours after he wrote it. So there is a degree of input on our part with what happens. And I think the trust that the writers and showrunners show in us, we all know the characters so well now. So I think it's important to have a dialogue with what happens.
We have a first AD, this guy Eric Pott, who's so good. This one of our executive producers, JPK, was directing that episode. Scott Gemmel was our showrunner and also the writer for these whole sequences. You know, having that discussion, saying, here's our fear, that we don't have a moment to emotionally connect to the beauty of this. You know, obviously it's this tumultuous recovery, but we need a moment of not brevity, but a reason to fight for these two. And then to go off and do that over a lunch, come back and trust to shoot it, is remarkable, especially on a show that's such a well-oiled machine that, you know, we're in season 8, for them to go, all right, let's adapt and go try this. I don't know if I've ever been a part of a project that was able to kind of on the fly make those kind of changes, which is amazing, and a tribute to those guys, to Gemmel and JPK and Eric Pott.